In this video, I will be showing you how to run and install Kali Linux Live on a USB flash drive with resistance. So first thing that you have to do is to come here and subscribe. Next thing, go to the Kali Linux official website. You can search it by in Google by searching Kali Linux and then select the first link. Once you go there, go to the download page. Download Kali Linux, we don't want anything else. Now, here are different kinds of images, like this is the Kali Linux installer, this is the Kali Linux Live, this is also the NIT installer, which is, we do not need it. And if you have like a torrent or something and you need to download using a torrent application or something, you can use this links. But since we are using external download manager, so we will just use this one. Once you select this one, there will be an option which I already have started it in download. So now I will just select and bring this one up. Yep, here. So once this download finishes, I will continue my video back. So until then, I will just pause my video. Now we need something else. We have to download Rufus. We will download the 3.15, this version. Okay, and once we downloaded this one, it should be here if we can see this one. Yeah, this is the reference. We just open it. It will prompt you for administration, just to, you know, make sure it is you and not someone else. And now just bring it on here. Now you need to put your flash in there. Okay, so this is the correct flash. Once you just insert the flash there, like you can see, no label. And now we will just wait for this final 7% of this file to download, and then we will just add this one there to the UFS and change some settings and then boot the flash. But just, we will just wait for this. We will be back when it's done. Okay, so once we see this option appears, it means that the download is done and it's saved in download / this file, right? Now just select the file and go to the here, downloads, and the Kali Linux, the first file should be. Okay, once you're here is the new option. It is called the persistence partition settings. So it is based on your USB drive. So mine is 32 gigabytes. I will make this one only 10. If you have like a, for example, if you have like a 8 gigabytes flash drive or some like 16 gigabytes, right, then you do it, for example, like 50-50. So if you have like 8 gigabytes, then do 4 gigabytes persistence. And if you have like a 16 gigabytes, then do like a 8 gigabytes persistence, or maybe like 7 gigabytes persistence. So I have 32, I will just do 10 gigabytes persistence. And we do not need to change any other settings. Yeah, everything seems fine. So now we don't need to change any other settings. Just select start, and this will, we'll just select yes, and let's see what happens. Okay, so all data on your will be destroyed, sure. Okay, now we will just wait for it for a few seconds. If you have like, it depends on your USB. If you have like a USB flash, okay, again, access denied. What is happening? All right, so I just resolved this one. I think it was because it was the security thought, the antivirus thought that this process is done by someone else, like, you know, online and stuff, because it needs to download some files too. That's why they blocked me, and now I just turned off my antivirus and now it is working. So this process depends totally on your USB flash drives and its speed. If your flash drive speed is like faster, you know, like 3.1 or 3.2 or something, right, then it'll be a lot faster. But if you have like a USB drive which is 2.0 or something, then it'll be a little slower. Now it is, if you see, it's formatting and it's already done. Now done. Now it'll format the flash, copy the in the ISO file. So it will take like some time, right? Like maybe some time. But you just need to be patient for that, and I will be patient in other way. I mean, I will just turn off my recording and I will start it again when it's done. Okay, great. So now if you see here, it is already says that it is ready. It means that it is already booted. No, not booted. How do I say that? So the USB is on the flash drive. Now we will go ahead and run this one from a laptop. You can run it from whatever you need, but or whatever you have, like a desktop or anything. But I have a laptop, so I will just run it in the laptop. All right, so once you come here, you whatever laptop you have, you just go to its boot menu. So, and this is, I have a Lenovo X250. You just press enter once you're starting, and then press F12, you're good. The boot menu. Once you come here, select the USB flash drive. I have a Samsung USB flash drive, and just select whatever you have and press enter. Once you press enter, it will go to the Cal Linux. So now you have a live system, live fail safe, and then you have here the live system persistence check kill. Okay, now you press this one. Once you press this one, it'll wait a little bit. It depends on your computer. If you have like a faster computer, it'll run faster. Or if you have a slower computer, it'll run slower. Now I have a medium computer, so it'll just run like a normal person. All right, so just wait for it until it's booted and ready to use. It doesn't have a password or anything. You, if you want to create a new user or something, you can just go ahead and use that. But from like the start, it doesn't have anything. So it just comes with the user, and you can use the root user by typing a sudo command or whatever you need or whatever you have. Okay, we'll just wait for it a little bit. Okay, so after like 20 million years later, here we are booted to our USB, and this is a Cal Linux. Everything is here. Now, just to test that the persistence works, so I will just create a new folder in here. I will name it a very good name, a very peaceful name. All right, here you go. Here is the file, right? Now I will just go ahead and restart my computer. Oh my god, takes forever, and I just accidentally pressed the wrong button too. Okay, so enter, and to go to the boot menu, press enter. Okay, and now press F12. I will press F12. Now it will take me forever just to load, but it's good, you know, not something to worry about. Come to my USB Samsung flash drive, and come to the persistence. Now it'll take again 1 million years to load, so that's why I will just stop the video. Okay, so now we are back to the Windows, oh sorry, to the Cal Linux thing, and we created a folder called you are the best, and here it is. It is still here. You are the best. All right, well, thank you. No, do not thank you. You should thank me for watching and learning something. And if you want to learn more, then just subscribe to the channel. Bye-bye. Peace.